the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. Morning is 697. 697. Bring your attention to a few things in the bulletin. I had someone come to me this morning
And they said, we're having the moose stew on Friday night. Everybody got their ticket for Friday night? Alan, we don't have a whole lot of tickets left over, do we? So if you, and I want you to know, this the moose tastes more like beef than moose. I'm just saying, I just want you to know that moose, I think that the moose might be related to the cow. Honest to goodness, I really do. So I'm just going to throw that out there. So we got a very cow moose. What would you call it? No, never mind. I'm not going there this morning. See, I might get sidetracked. If you had takeout, because some folks said, I want to have takeout. So if you got takeout, please bring your pot, because the containers, we want to make, we don't want the containers, those plastic containers, in case it's hot enough that you'd have an accident. We don't want that. So bring a pot with you so that you can get your takeout, and we'll look out to you proper. So everybody heard that? Good. Okay. And there's a lot happening in February, so we're going to continue on. Monday night is our continued study for about Abraham. However, Bible study, you know the rule. If there's a winter storm out, we're not having Bible study, right? I don't want nobody to be falling and hurting themselves. So be careful, and it's the rule of common sense. So there's a bowling night in February as well. So I want you to make note of that. There's the AGM next weekend. Oh my goodness, we're going to have a beef supper with the... Is it a beef sandwich? Beef dinner? Beef sandwich? Beef sandwich. Oh, roast beef sandwich. Moose on Friday night, roast beef sandwich on Sunday night. We're going to be fed up is what we're going to be. So I'm looking forward to all of this, and we're going to have a wonderful time together. So please come out to these things. Sheila, am I missing anything? Oh, the breakfast, men's breakfast is coming up as well. Oh, pancake supper is coming up. Oh my goodness. Can't forget pancake supper. We like to eat around here. Do you notice our theme? You know, we're going to become a heavy church, literally.
Ecumenical service.
Oh, and the ecumenical service, of course, that is happening. The town came to the ministerial and said, would we do a service in the Clarenville Winter Carnival? So we're going to do a gospel concert, and I know that it's going to be wonderful. Can I have the children please come forward? I've been looking forward to you all morning. Can I have the children please come forward? And the names for our loved ones that we're praying for is on the altar this morning.
Come on up, honey. Can I go sit beside you this morning? Oh, that's awesome. Oh, you had the bag.
You did? Cool.
Good morning. And what's your name?
James. Well, James, really nice to meet you, James. We have the bag here. And inside the bag there might be something. There's been times that there's been nothing in the bag, but I don't mind having nothing in the bag, too. So are you ready? Oh, you'd be ready because you put something in the bag. It's not alive, though, right? No. That's the one rule. Nothing alive in the bag. Okay. We have... No, it's not quite. I don't know whether it is. Choir, I want you to... Oh, okay. It's a Lego comic book. Okay, let's sit back down now.
Lego,
what?
Lego Nexo Knights.
Oh, you want me to say that now? Lego Nexo Knights? Is that it? Okay. Whoa, first try. Okay. Lego Nexo Knights. And we've got all the Lego stuff there, and they're on the I-beam, and they're having lunch up there. Yeah. And then some fellas down here, they're painting away.
That's how you're supposed to make tables, not
Legos. Oh, that's how you're supposed to make tables. I think they're making buildings off there.
Yeah, they're having a little lunch.
Yeah, they're having a little lunch. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. So inside the book, so This is a Lego comic book. And so how can we know what the story is?
You read it.
You read it. Okay. And so if we were going to use a Lego comic book, how would we tell someone about Jesus? By using a Lego comic book.
From the war.
From the war. Oh, the knights, okay, knights in shining armor, okay.
And God also
made Legos, okay. I like this. See, I learned, you know, they teach us so much.
Oh.
Yes, there is. So the only way, okay, I think what I'll do is, can I take over this morning and I'll tell you something about Jesus instead of you guys? Okay, is that okay with you? All right. What I like about a Lego comic book is that the only way you can discover what's inside is to open it up and actually what? And read it. And that's how we discover what the story is, right? That's how we discover what the story is. And Legos come with it. Okay, you can hold this one. I want to show you another book.
And someone said it's instructions, I think. Somewhere. This is my favorite book.
Do I have a book for you? Do you know what this book is?
A Bible.
It is a Bible. Let's see which one is bigger. Okay. I think my book's bigger than your book.
Yeah.
But I want you to know something about your book and my book. The only way that we can know the story is to actually open it and read it. And that is the same as your book. And I want you to know that the Bible has a lot of good things to teach us. But one of the most important things that the Bible teaches us, do you know what that is?
Jesus.
And how does he feel about you? Jesus loves you. That's the most important thing to know. Isn't that awesome? Okay, I'm going to put my book back. You hold your book. Okay. Just a second. I'm coming. Now, can you put your hands in the air? Can you put your hands up in the air? And twinkle your fingers. Twinkle your fingers. Okay, and we're going to make a big clap in 1, 2, 3. Oh, that's awesome. Okay. Clark, fun. That worked. Okay, can we do it together though? Dear Jesus, thank you for today, for all our fun at work and play. Thank you for your Bible that we can read and learn about you and how much you love us. Amen. Boys and girls, there is some school. I like this one. I know. Okay. You want to watch some school? There you go. Okay. Rebecca, are you going to go to Sunday school? They're going to Sunday school.
Folks,
How many people really enjoy the children's time? Can I just see how many people? Do you enjoy the children's time? Isn't it an amazing time? It is really an amazing time, isn't it? I learned so much from them, but listen, I want you to consider, I don't care how old you are, I don't care how young you are, but I want you to consider this. We need Sunday school teachers. It's because we have children in our church, and we want to provide for them because we have always had a wonderful children's program, but we're running short on our teachers. And so please consider offering yourself for one Sunday a month to be a Sunday school teacher. I would deeply appreciate that, and you can talk to Lana or myself, and we would certainly direct you in that way. It's not difficult, and actually, as you can tell from the front, it's kind of fun too. Okay? Let's stand together, folks. The gathering of the community is found in your bulletin. People of God, rejoice in God's presence.
And praise and praise God is with us.
People of God, rejoice in this faith community.
As we support each other, as we reach out helping hand, God is with us.
People of God, rejoice in your Christian faith.
As we follow the way of Jesus, as we proclaim his good news, God is with us.
Merciful Lord, grant to your faithful people pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the proclamation of our word.
Our first reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 58, verses 1 to 12. The Lord says, "Shout as loud as you can. Tell my people, Israel, about their sins. They worship me every day, claiming that they are eager to know my ways and obey my laws. They say they want to give them just laws. They say they want me to give them just laws, and that they take pleasure in worshiping me. The people ask, 'We should fast. Why should we fast if the Lord never notices? Why should we go without food if he pays no attention?' The Lord says to them, 'The truth is that at the same time you fast, you pursue your own interests and oppress your workers. Your fasting makes you violent and you quarrel and fight. Do you think this kind of fasting will make me listen to your prayers? Do you think this kind of... When you fast, you make yourselves suffer. You bow your heads low like a blade of grass and spread out sackcloth and ashes to lie on. Is that what you call fasting? Do you think I will be pleased with that? The kind of fasting I want is this: remove the chains of oppression and the yoke of injustice, and let the oppressed go free. Share your food with the hungry and open your homes to the homeless and the poor. Give clothes to those who have nothing to wear, and do not refuse to help your own relatives. Then my favor will shine on you like the morning sun, and your wounds will be quickly healed. I will always be with you to save you. My presence will protect you on every side." When you call to me, I will respond. If you put an end to oppression, to every gesture of contempt, and to every evil word, if you give food to the hungry and satisfy those who are in need, then the darkness around you will turn into the brightness of noon. And I will always guide you and satisfy you with good things. I will keep you strong and well. You will be like a garden that has plenty of water, like a spring of water that never goes dry. Your people will rebuild what has long been in ruins, building again on the old foundations. You will be known as the people who rebuilt the walls and who restored the ruined houses. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The appointed psalm for this morning is Psalm 112, found on page 860. Psalm 112, we shall read by the half verse. Please stand. Hallelujah! Happy are they who fear the Lord.
And happy are the Lord who fears His commandments.
Their descendants will be mighty in the land.
Generation of the upright will be blessed.
Wealth and riches will be in their house.
And their righteousness will last forever.
Light shines in the darkness for the upright.
The righteous are merciful and full of compassion.
It is good for them to be generous in lending.
And to manage their affairs to justice.
For they will never be shaken.
The righteous will inherit in everlasting remembrance.
They will not be afraid of any evil rumors.
Their heart is right. They put their trust in the Lord.
Their heart is established and will not shrink
until they see the desire upon their enemies.
They have given freely to the poor.
And their righteousness stands fast forever. They will hold up their head with honor.
The wicked will see it and be angry. They will gnash their teeth and pine away.
The desires of the wicked will perish.
God of light,
teach us to love each other as you love us, that we may bring peace and joy to the world, and rejoice in the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Reading from Corinthians, chapter 2, verses 1 to 16, a reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, I did not come proclaiming the mysteries of God to you in lofty words or wisdom. For I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. And I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of the Spirit and of power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet among the mature we do speak wisdom, though it is not a wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age, who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love Him. These things God has revealed to us through the Spirit, for the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what human being knows, what is truly human, except the human spirit that is within. So also no one comprehends what is truly God except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit that is from God, so that we may understand the gifts bestowed on us by God. And we speak of these things in words not taught by human wisdom, but taught by the Spirit, interpreting spiritual things to those who are spiritual. Those who are unspirit do not receive the gifts of God's Spirit, for they are foolishness to them, and they are unable to understand them because they are spiritually disconcerned. Those who are spiritually disconcerned know the mind of the Lord. Those who are spiritually disconcerned all things, and they are themselves subject to no one else's scrutiny. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to instruct them? But we have the mind of Christ.
Our gradual hymn is hymn number 92.
Oh, see, as they know.
fasted. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter, will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and the Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. God is already here. Can't you feel His presence? He's already here. All we have to do is open up our hearts, for He is already. I really love talking about Jesus, and I love talking about Jesus to the children. It's one of my favorite subjects, and it should be because I'm your minister. You know, it's always a good thing when the minister likes to talk about Jesus. And I want you to know there is another subject. I wonder if you guys would know this by now, that I do like talking about. Does anybody know almost my second favorite topic for talking about? Besides spiritual matters, there's another topic. Food. And I want to talk to you a little bit about food this morning, because one of the ingredients for this sermon this morning is the salt. Now, I want you to be honest with me this morning. Can we have an honest moment? I'm going to ask you, how many people use salt on their food? Come on. How many people are lying? Yeah. Isn't it wonderful? You know, you can have whatever it is. I know that I had planned for supper tonight. I had planned a roast. And with that, we're going to have potatoes and vegetables. With that, I'm going to make gravy, and I'm going to do all the fixings. And of course, every once in a while when I'm doing up the gravy, I don't put quite enough salt when you're doing your gravy. So when you taste the gravy on the first the forkful, then you go for the salt shaker. And you sprinkle a little bit. I want you to know that I don't use so much salt now, but I love pepper. But anyway, we're talking about salt this morning. And how it adds to that moment in my mind, because I believe that it must be a mind thing, because as it was in the beginning, and it's now and ever shall be, world without end, amen. My father used it, my parents used it, and their parents used it, and so on and so on. And I think we're in the habit of shaking it a little bit too much.
But folks, here it is. This morning, they come up with this, and salt has always been a very important ingredient to the Old Testament people, the New Testament people, and here we are, and it's important to this reading this morning. And Jesus is using it for an example. He says, imagine if salt lost its saltiness. Now, I want you to know something. Every once in a while, my mom, she had a sense of humor. And she would take sugar and put it in the salt shaker. How many people did that? Because she was thinking that we were using too much salt, and she was going to fix our little red wagons. And, of course, she would put sugar in the salt shaker. But imagine the expectation that we would go with of wanting to taste one thing and that taste not there. Jesus is telling us this morning is if we lose our purpose, that's what he's talking about this morning. If salt loses its saltiness, it loses its purpose for existence. Then he says, he goes further and he wants to bring us in. I love how Jesus is always a fisherman, because he uses that example, he baits the hook, and then he starts to reel us in. And then he says, you know, if we light a lamp, do we put it under the bowl? And can you imagine what happens to the light if you put the bowl over it? It would eventually, it goes out. Because it burns up its resources, and when there's no more resources available to it, it cannot exist anymore. Purpose and resources. We are living our lives, and we have Jack here this morning. I love babies. Jack's so quiet, though. Why can't he be crying? Oh, that's what it is. You know, Jack has been given such a wonderful life. Through his life, he is going to have purpose in this life. He's going to have not only the purpose to live, but he's going to have the resources that God gives him in his natural ability, his natural talents. You and I have been given all of these same things. We've been given life, which is a gift from God. We've been given ability and talents, resources to be able to live out our existence and remain connected to our spiritual source. And I was talking about this yesterday, is that, you know, we are Trinity people, mind, body, and spirit, and we always forget about our spirit sometimes. And we don't remember to feed that, and when we don't feed our spiritual tank, it's kind of like having a great blazing fire in the stove, and you get it going in the morning and you forget about it in the afternoon, and come supper time, what has happened to the fire? We need to continue to feed that resource. As we are feeding ourselves spiritually, continuing with that purpose that God has called us to, because he calls us with purpose. He calls Jack with purpose. He calls his mom and dad with purpose. Because he called you to be his parents. His mom and dad. I know, Amanda still can't believe that she's a mom. And he gave you guys that purpose to fulfill. And I know you're going to do a wonderful job. And I know that you come from good stuff. I made a plug for you, Freeman. See that? I just plugged it. And you know what? That's called the family. And this family is here as part of that huger family that brings purpose to this church. And if you're here this morning with us, you're here because you have purpose to be a part of this family. which is the body of Christ. And I want to tell you this, don't lose your purpose. It's so easy to, you know, as you get snuggled in that bed, you find that sweet spot. How come on Sunday morning you find the sweet spot? You find that sweet spot and you think to yourself, I could just stay right here. Someone can relate, did you hear that? I could just stay right here. Then something reminds you, oh yeah, you're the minister. You've got to get up and go. Oh, folks, he calls you with such great purpose in mind. He has your life in his mind. He has your destiny in store for you. And as we live each day to the very best of our ability, he gives us this promise. He will be our helper. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Heavenly Father, indeed, you give us that purpose. You give us that resource to be able to live out the life that you have called us to live. May we continue to remain strong in your spirit. Strong in your spirit to live out the life that you have called each one of us to live. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to invite my servers to come and lead us down to the back of the church. That's awesome. Thank you. Thank you, Jack. And so on page 153, in the middle of the page, you're going to be responding with, I present. And I ask this question, Jack will now be presented for baptism. I present. And you guys say together,
right here.
I present
Jack
to receive.
Jack Freeman Craig.
To receive the sacrament of baptism. Okay, so we know what we're saying now. So now we're going to try it again. All right, Jack will now be presented for baptism. I present Jack Craig to receive the sacrament of baptism. Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is nurtured in the faith and the life of the Christian community? I will, with God's help. Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ? I will, with God's help. Do you renounce Satan and all spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? I renounce them. Do you renounce the evil powers of this world, which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce the sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to obey him as your Lord?
I do.
Now, to the whole congregation here present, will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this family and their life in Christ?
Let us now pray for this child who is to receive the sacrament of new birth. Deliver him, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open his heart to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill him with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach him to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send him into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring him to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We give you thanks, Almighty God and Father, for the gift of water. You nurture and sustain all living things.
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks that through the waters of the Red Sea, you led your people out of slavery to freedom in the Promised Land.
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks for sending your Son, Jesus. For us, he was baptized by John in the River Jordan. For us, he was anointed as Christ by the Holy Spirit. For us, he suffered the baptism of his own death and resurrection, setting us free from the bondage of sin and death, and opening to us the joy and freedom of everlasting life. We give you
Blessed be God forever.
We give you thanks for your Holy Spirit, who teaches us and leads us into all truth, filling us with the gifts so that we might proclaim the gospel to all nations and serve you as a royal priesthood.
Blessed be God forever.
We give thanks for you have called Jack to a new life through the waters of baptism. Now sanctify this water that your servant, who are washed in it, may be made one with Christ in his body, death, and resurrection, to be cleansed and delivered from sin. Anoint him with your Holy Spirit and bring him to new birth in the family of your church, that they may become inheritors of your glorious kingdom. We give you praise and honor and worship through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Blessed are you, our strength and song, and our salvation.
Let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will with God's help.
That
This is just absolutely wonderful. Hello, Jack. Yes, you just want everyone to know that you're here. Yeah. That's totally fine, buddy. You just let it go. Jack, Freeman, Craig, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Oh, that's a good cry. Oh, that's wonderful. Yes. I sign you with the sign of the cross, and I mark you for Christ all and forever. Amen. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by the water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon this your servant the forgiveness of sins, and has raised him to new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and a discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, the spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Amen. Receive the light of Christ to show that you have passed from darkness to light.
Let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
And now we have a special presentation for you as well from our ACW.
These are your certificates.
Thank you very much. The colored ones are for mom and dad, and the black and whites are for your godparents. Okay. Congregation, let us welcome the newly baptized. We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. And now let us welcome little Jack to us. Thank you, Lord. Now I'm going to ask our servers to come and lead us back. I'm going to take Jack because I get to go show Mom.
Ladies.
Thanks, sweetie. Oh, they come up to the baby.
Jack is so cute.
communion is found in our bulletin, and we pray together. Eternal God, in you we find peace, O God, all time.
May you be there in this heavenly banquet, the instruments of your peace on earth. In the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen.
And now may the peace of God that passes all human understanding keep your hearts and your minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you all, remain with you all always, and those whom you love forevermore. Amen. Amen. Our closing hymn today is 559.